Remember Devin AI? It was released in March 2024, and the company said that it was the world's first AI software engineer. And everyone thought that it would steal the jobs of actual software engineers, actual human software engineers. The company published a demo where Devin AI planned and executed a task from start to end without any human intervention. And everyone was impressed. We all thought, here is this AI tool that can take orders, complete a task, and deploy something. And this could mean the end of human software engineers. But then some smart people did a deep dive and found out that the company may have been over-exaggerating and maybe lying about Devin AI's capabilities. This blog article here gives a really good explanation of how the task that Devin AI completed during the demo was actually cherry-picked specifically for the demo. And they also mentioned quite a few inconsistencies with the demo. But that led me to the question. It's been 18 months since ChatGPT has been released, which started the whole AI revolution. At the moment, is it actually possible for AI to replace a human software engineer? In 2024, a company called GetClear published an interesting paper. They did some research on GitHub's Copilot. Now, if you haven't heard of Copilot, Copilot is a coding editor which essentially can create AI-generated code depending on the prompt or what you tell it to do. Here is an example of how Copilot works. You comment something that you want on your code, the AI uses it as a prompt and answers your prompt with corresponding code. And as you can see, this can be useful for software engineers. And when Copilot was released, GitHub was saying that developers will write code 55% more faster with Copilot, which makes sense. I believe that. I can see how this would save me time. Now, GetClear, the consulting and research company, well, they wanted to know how does code quality produced by AI actually compare to the code written by a human? And they did find some pretty insightful things. So they collected about 153 million changed lines of code, which were authored between January 2020 and December 2023. That is a lot of lines of code. And they published a paper. These are the findings. So the study found an increase in code churn. Now, code churn is any code that is added to your repository, technically ready to be deployed, but then actually quickly removed or modified. And if that happens, it generally means that there was a mistake. So the code churn actually jumped from 3.3% in 2020 to a projected 7.1% in 2024. And this trend does indicate that there might be a rise in the amount of mistakes appearing in your code, which often requires some sort of rework or deletion. The other key finding is about copy and pasted code. They noticed that there is a notable rise in the amount of copy and pasted code. So code that is quite duplicated throughout the script. So the copy and pasted code was measured at 11.6% in 2024, which is really up from 8.3% in 2020. So this trend obviously indicates that developers are creating repetitive code, which makes future updates and maintenance quite hard. I have noticed that AI isn't too great with that, and it does repeat lines of code. And the other thing I noticed is that the proportion of moved code has also decreased. So generally, if you are moving code or refactoring it, it means that you are making an effort to tidy up your code. Now, the amount of move code has actually declined from 25% in 2020 to 13.4% in 2024. And it does imply that less effort is put in the designing and restructuring of your code. And you'll notice that when you are creating a long, intense script, often you'll go back, move code around, neaten it up, etc. It is part of your code quality. However, they are noticing a decline in this because that's something that AI would not do. So with that, we know that AI does definitely save developers' time. I've saved time with AI, but it may not be creating the best code in terms of code quality. So someone on Reddit posted, "Am I the only one who thinks AI is going to result in software getting worse than it already is?" And I found this comment really interesting. It's making new devs have to work less to find solutions. So when they encounter issues that aren't getting solved by just popping it back in ChatGPT or Copilot, then they're lost AF. That's our future. And it's true. When you're starting to learn to code by yourself, the best thing that you can do is just do it by yourself, make mistakes, and learn how to fix it. Using AI doesn't actually make you a better coder. Here's another post not too long ago from someone asking how to get people to stop blaming and overusing AI. And within their text, they actually said, one project is using 3 to 4 different libraries for making HTTP requests at this point because ChatGPT isn't consistent in what it uses and devs aren't checking to see what already is in place. And if you are a junior developer or an intern, something like that won't really raise a flag because if you run the code, it would probably still run. There's actually an interesting blog article from a machine learning engineer at Google, where he speaks about AI replacing software engineers. And here he says the software engineer skill that's valuable is solving the problems, not actually writing the code, which is so true. AI is great to use for boilerplates, templates, and maybe simple bug fixes. I use it all the time, but a lot of people generally agree if you're learning to code and you are a junior engineer, just don't use AI. For example, here's a question. Learning programming using ChatGPT or not? Top answer here is the problem is that it always gives confident answers. Answers are always fully explained and always look good, but sometimes they are completely wrong. I've run a few queries on AI where I know what the answer should be, but the response I actually get from AI is wrong. And looking back, if I was a bit more inexperienced, I may not have picked that up. I really like this response as well. Use it as a colleague. You'd ask a colleague questions, help explain concepts, etc., but you wouldn't ask a colleague to write all of the code for you. I don't think a software engineer, a human software engineer, would trust AI completely at the moment. We know it hallucinates. We know that it makes stuff up and it passes it as being correct. And that part there is always going to be a limit. In fact, recently Google released an AI overview, which is a new feature of theirs in the Google search. You make a Google search and you get this little AI summary, which can be useful. Users reported that it had crazy hallucinations, even telling people to add glue to their pizza. I actually posted a video about this. And they've released a blog post and they said that they are fixing it. And some of the queries that people were asking were a bit random and strange, hence the random and strange answers from AI. But like it or not, it still proves that hallucinations are there, they're present, and nobody is able to fix it yet. There's an article from Scientific American, which actually quotes, but many machine learning experts don't view hallucination as fixable because it stems from LLMs doing exactly what they developed and trained to do so, respond however they can to user prompts. It is part of the LLM model, and unfortunately, presenting itself as being right so confidently when it is quite wrong, that can often be a big issue, especially if you think about it in a production environment. For large-scale companies, the risk is a lot more. So, until there is some way that fact-checking can happen in real time, I don't see how AI would replace a good software engineer. The only thing that may happen, and probably might be happening already, is that AI can increase the productivity of a software engineering team, and maybe that results in the team not needing as many engineers as previously. But I can't really see a situation anytime in the near future where my coworkers will be AI, which is a good thing. Finding a job in software engineering is hard, but at the moment, I don't think it is hard because of AI. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my content, please like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you on the next one.